ओके स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सम वेरी क्यूट टॉपिक्स. ओके, ऑड इवन प्रिंसिपल एंड मैजिक नंबर, दीज आर द टू स्मॉल टॉपिक्स विच आई एम गोइंग टू कवर इन वेरी फ्यू मिनट्स. आई विल नॉट टेक मच टाइम. एक्चुअली दीज आर द टॉपिक्स विच आर रिलेटेड, डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चंस आर कमिंग, दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव टू सेपरेटली कवर दीज टू टॉपिक. ऑड इवन प्रिंसिपल, नॉट द दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट प्रिंसिपल, odd even and magic numbers. Okay, what is magic numbers? Actually, like electronic configuration, suppose if you take the 2 is neon. Okay, so 2, 8, this is full filled subshell. Okay, actually this is contains what, 2s2 2p6, so this is called as a closed shell. What do we call it as? A closed shell, otherwise fully filled configuration. Okay, so because of this, the neon is chemically unreactive. Chemically unreactive means chemically stable. So like that principle is also applicable for the stability of the nucleus. Like atoms are stable because of the 8 electrons in their valence shell. Same way, nucleus is said to be closed. Okay, what it is called? Closed shell. Understood? There we call it as a fully filled subshell, here we call it as a closed shell. Okay, but there electrons, here it will be neutrons and protons. Okay, so but reason behind it is not known, that's why this is called as a magic numbers. Okay, so any nucleus containing 2 proton, 8 proton, 20 proton, 28 proton, 50 proton, 82 protons. Okay, it is considered to be stable because their shell, proton shell, is closed. Like we call it as a 8 electron fully filled second subshell. Okay, 18 electron fully filled third shell. Likewise, 6 electron p subshell fully filled. 10 electron d subshell fully filled. Like that, the protons, if these numbers are there, then it is considered as a closed shell. And for neutron also same, 2 8 20 28 50 82, but one more number is added. What is that? 126. Okay, then they are, it is also considered as a closed shell. Okay, so these number, any nucleus containing these number of protons or these number of neutrons are highly stable, but reason is not known, that's why these numbers are called as magic numbers. Magic numbers are 2 8 20 28 50 82. In case of the neutrons, another number it is 126. Magic number, is it understood? Just make a note of it, and we are going to start with odd even. How to find out which is stable, which is unstable, depending on the number of neutron and proton. Okay, we will do some examples also. Like why lead is, here this question will be, why lead is highly stable, nucleus is highly, it is least radioactive, why? Okay, this question is to you all. Why it is, you can find out with the help of the magic number. Okay, this question is related to what? Magic number. You can find out and tell me. You can write this answer in the comment section. Then we'll start with the odd even. Okay, here I am telling you about the odd even principle. Okay, so let us take atomic number is even and number of neutrons are also even. See, both are even, these many number of nucleates are stable. That means both even, then it is going to be a wonderful stable. Wonderfully stable means least radioactive. Understood? These many number of nucleates found where their atomic number is also even and number of neutrons also even. That is, simply we can say proton also. Atomic number means proton only. So number of proton or atomic number also even and number of neutron also. Both even is a good sign. Okay. Then it is, see, these many people have already stabilized. Okay. If atomic number is even, then number of neutrons are not even, then also no problem. Stable, still they are stable. Odd and even, at least neutrons are even. Okay, atomic number is not even, then also stable. But the stability when both are even is wonderful. When one of them are even is less stable. When both are odd, only rare case, only 8 nucleates are stable with both odd. Understood? So like this, how the question they will frame, I will tell you with one example. Make a note of it. Okay? Okay, here this is the question based upon the above odd even principle. They are given, you forget about this, you can even x, y or z also, no problem. Okay, so x, y, z are with having atomic number this, mass number this, which is likely to be radioactive and why? Tell me. So here simply after subtracting, this is even, z is even. After subtracting this also even, even minus even you will get even number, stable, non-radioactive. Even minus even you will get stable. Okay, here this is even, this is odd. So after subtracting already Z is odd. Okay, what is that? Atomic number is odd. And number of neutrons also is going to be odd. If both are odd then definitely. So if both are odd then definitely it is going to be radioactive. Okay, so final answer is this is radioactive. Let them give PQR, then this final is going to be radioactive. This is how you will identify radioactive substance or not based upon the odd and even. Okay, I hope you understood this. Okay, bye bye.